From Philadelphia, as well as hints that xylazine was appearing in other parts of the country, prompted the researchers and colleagues to try to track the drug's spread across the continental United States. Xylazine was found in 0.36% of overdose deaths in 2015, according to research. It increased to 6.7% by 2020. It was found in 1 out of every 5 overdose deaths in some areas. Notably, the study discovered fentanyl, a powerful synthetic opioid that has come to dominate regional drug supplies in nearly every xylazine-related death, indicating that it wasn't just the tranquilizer that was causing these overdoses. Experts are still trying to understand the risk of xylazine, but they are concerned that the drug, which is not an opioid but acts as a sedative, may increase the chances of fatal overdose when combined with opioids like fentanyl because it can exacerbate the respiratory depression caused by opioids. It may also make reversing overdoses with naloxone, which is designed to work on opioids, more difficult. The drug overdose crisis in the United States has been steadily worsening and is now killing more than 100,000 people per year. Foundation or in a good home, but they can still begin using drugs. The truth is that people use drugs for a variety of reasons, and they become addicted for a variety of reasons. or sexual in the past. 3. Genetic vulnerability, such as other family members who struggle with addiction. 4. Prenatal alcohol or drug exposure while in the womb. Five, lack of parental supervision or monitoring during adolescence, peer pressure from friends or social circles, or A euphoric bodily response and mental state in the user, making him or her feel good or high. When the brain is exposed to this on a regular basis, it becomes reliant on the feel-good behavior. As a result, it hardwires those euphoric drug-using experiences into its circuitry, and drug use becomes its top priority. These are physical changes that will occur. The brain's reward system, a primitive system that exists to ensure we seek what we need, becomes hardwired to prioritize drug use over all other activities. Such as eating, sleeping, family, and academics. Even when the drugs no longer provide pleasure to the user, which happens over time as the user becomes tolerant to them, the brain continues to push this need. It causes intense craving in the same part of the brain as the survival instinct. Despite the fact that drug addiction causes physical and chronic changes in the brain, there is good news. The brain can be rewired back to normal. Substance abuse is, in fact, very treatable and manageable. It is not an overnight solution. It takes time for the brain to rewire back to a healthier state, just as it took time for the person's brain to rewire in favor of drug use. Addiction recovery necessitates changes in routines and thought processes. It entails substituting healthy behaviors such as exercise and cooking for drug use. It also entails reframing a person's perspective and definition of drug use. And to dismiss drug cravings over time. It is possible to teach it to seek and prioritize meaningful relationships and activities over drugs and alcohol. Abstinence, ongoing therapy, active management, cognitive reframing, and professional support can all be used to teach this. As the homelessness crisis worsened, there has been numerous attempts to regulate in Kensington encampments. Estimated over 650 people.